As a child, I resided in one of America's most notorious ghettos. Brownsville is located in the far east end of Brooklyn. We were far enough away from the high rises of Manhattan that any trip into it was called going into the city, as if we were embarking on a long, perilous trek. In the streets of Brownsville, the radio was always on. The music flowed out of tenement windows, passing cars, and the transistor radios of people carrying them in their hands. Even as winter arrived in late 1969, music slid from under metal public housing doors when I went up to put garbage in the incinerator at night. Because Brownsville was a Black and Puerto Rican neighborhood, their music was primarily soul and salsa. Guitars were rhythm instruments. Screaming lead guitars were, in the world we grew up in, for white boys with long hair and weird band names, and was played on stations we skipped past on the dial. On the nights Jimi Hendrix recorded Band of Gypsys in Manhattan's East Village, Brownsville might as well have been the other side of the moon.
A band of gypsies.
We knew there was a black guy with crazy clothes who'd been written up in the newspapers, but we had no sonic reference for him or why he was important. But that would change in a few months. That summer of 1970, a funny thing happened. Adolescence kicked in, and the axis of our taste began to shift. One day that spring, I and a few other friends went over to Jimmy's family's apartment and entered his room. Hung over his bed was a huge poster of Jimi Hendrix. The guitarist stood against a blue sky while shredding on his white Strat. Mouth open, head to the sky. What the fuck was our collective reaction? In our world of musical heroes, the flashy, druggy Sly Stone was about as far out as we went. But Hendrix was from another planet. With this band, Hendrix had created his own brand of funk. When it penetrates the soul, even as it delights the ears. There are several generations of axemen for whom Band of Gypsies provided a way of hearing low-ended funk music over which a guitar could shred or groove or dance gracefully between the two. For me, it was a gateway drug to many forms of musical addiction. I don't know if Band of Gypsies is Hendrix's most innovative recording. I do know something more important than that. It changed lives.